Hi everybody, hope you're doing marvellously well. I'm wearing my rather lovely Focal Clear Pro headphones. These are beautiful and they're about as flat as anything I own. Why are we doing this? Because today we're going to talk about master bus compression. So many of you know about the magic of the SSL bus compressor. It is inarguably the most copied bus compressor in the planet. And I have an SSL console with, of course, an SSL 4000 bus compressor. I have versions of this, I have the real deal, and I have all of the plugins. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how you use it on a console, some of the most familiar settings, and then we're going to look at some of the plugins that are out there and just kind of get a feel for it, see how it compares, and just generally learn how mixers use master bus compression. So let's start with just talking a little bit about the console. So here it is. Here is our lovely bus compressor, SSL 4000 bus compressor, the one and only. Up at the top here, of course, we have the VU meter. It says dB for decibel, of course, and compression. And that will indicate how much compression is being applied. Obviously, like anything, you want to be using your ears. But that is a great indication as well, obviously. So here is our threshold control. The moment it's fully open, meaning it won't be compressing at all. But as I bring it back on the signal, you'll see more compression applied. Immediately opposite this is the gain makeup. The more compression that's indicated here and that you start to hear as this threshold comes back, you'll want to apply more gain makeup so that as you turn it on and off, my bulb's blown, but as you turn it on and off, you'll get a balanced signal. So you'll hear something which is pretty similar, compressed to uncompressed. Next up is attack and release. The attack control typically is set most of the time. I set it over here to like the slowest I possibly can. I don't want it to be too aggressive because that doesn't give me that glued SSL sound. And the other thing most of us do is always use the auto function. Too fast a release typically is not a good sound on an SSL. It gives you that choppy kind of sound. You're going to find most professional mixers will start with auto and only really mess with the release time over here if they're dealing with something which is so unbelievably sample accurate. Now, what I mean by that is something is super chopped up, like an EDM track, and you can rely on those eighth notes hitting consistently like this. You can get really clever with your release, but there's something wonderful about SSL's auto function. We'll mess around with it and you can hear. Ratio is typically set on an SSL from 4 to 1, and 4 meaning it takes 4 decibels over where the threshold is set for 1 to come out. I was watching a video recently by somebody I respect and they did not explain it very well. Because basically what that means is every time it goes over the threshold, 4 dB, it will reduce it by 3, meaning only 1 dB will come over. It takes 4 dB for 1 dB to go through. So 10 to 1 would be very, very aggressive. It would take 10 dB for 1 dB to get through. And some compressors, obviously like 1176, have 20 to 1 ratios, which is a really aggressive. And then, of course, in digital, you can have full brick wall limiting, meaning nothing will go through. And then, of course, as I said before, we have an on-off control here, which the bulb has blown, but you're going to hear it work. So let's take a little loop of a track, which is very organic with tons of verb on it. Let's have a listen. Bring this threshold back. You can really hear it catching that kick. Take it out. This is that thump. Take it out again. It's a perceptible volume difference. It's mainly the kick it's catching, but I could bring up the gain makeup a bit. Out. In. Pretty beautiful. We can mess up around with the release time, go to the fastest. See, even on that fastest release time, out, in, auto. Back to the fastest. Take it out. Back in. On that auto setting, it just seems to hold on to it a little bit longer, but in a nice way. So let's go back. Far too long. Out. Second shortest. And then the fastest release time. Out. Go back to auto. The auto function or the fastest works for me. But on the fastest, I'm going to bring the gain reduction down. The gain makeup down, I should say. Check it out. That's auto. Pretty nice. Subtlety is the name of the game. We're not grabbing it massively aggressively. I mean, we're getting 1 to 2, maybe a peak on 3 dB worth of gain reduction, but that's a lot. Most of the time, it's 1 or 2 dB worth of gain reduction, and it's just gluing things together nicely. But we can get a bit more aggressive on some other tracks. So I have a track here by Chase K. It's got some aggressive kind of kicks and snares poking their heads out. So this is going to, we're going to listen to how the attack and the release is working on this. So we'll turn the compression off. Let's have a listen. Reset everything. Bring it in. He's getting older. Make up the gain. Each year a little colder. So this is getting older. Take it out. So with it off. Each year a little colder. Bring it in. Oh, it's really punchy. Let's make sure it's not a volume difference, so we'll bring the output gain down a little bit. So this is getting older. Each year a little colder. This is out. Isn't that snare? So this is getting older. Put it in. Each year a little colder. What you clearly hear there is that SSL sound. When the snare's playing with the bus compressor just catching essentially the snare, it does that piff, piff kind of, I don't know how to explain it, but just that sound of an SSL. It's really unique, it's really wonderful, and it glues it into the track. The rest of the energy of the track came up. But it didn't perceptibly, the peaks were controlled really, really nicely. And it just gives us that drum sound that we all know and love and that sounds like a professional record. Let's be honest, there's something about the SSL sound since the very late 70s with guys like, of course, Hugh Padgham and Steve Lillywhite making so many records on SSLs. Obviously, Hugh massively famously for making records on SSLs. That sound just became synonymous with everything. Right through probably until the early mid-2000s, pretty much every major record you heard was mixed on an SSL. Maybe even a little longer, depending on how you look at it. Obviously, now so many of us are in the box, but that SSL sound is something we know. That's why we're getting into SSL-style plugins. So here we have Christina's track. It's got a djembe. I've got a low mic underneath the djembe itself, which means it's picking up a heck of a lot of low end. Let's go back and reset everything. We can turn it off, but it's completely reset. And let's play the track and listen to this low end. Huge. So put it in. Fastest attack. Something splatty about that fast attack. Go back to the auto. Let's try a slowest. Grabbing it far too hard. Going slower and slower. That's the fastest release time. And there's auto. That's the fastest. I like it on fastest at the moment. Decrease the attack time. It's faster. Oh, look at that. Take it out. Bring the makeup gain up. I mean, I like what it's doing, but have a listen to it now. So this is with it in, let's take it out. This is that low end, it's massive. Put this in. Really aggressively catching the low end and also the top hand hitting the top of the djembe. Out. And back in. So you're probably thinking, Warren, what is the point you're trying to make? Well, for me, that low end, it's not working with the SSL bus compressor. On a mix, I'm going to have to be very, very careful because the low end is going to control the compression otherwise. So that's where plugins and modern compressors come in. There's some hardware, like, of course, the Tegeler, which we absolutely love, and that has a side chain in it, meaning you can vary how much low end passes before the compressor grabs hold of it. And that is huge, especially for modern music where we have extended low end, which we didn't have back in the days of vinyls. So when you listen to old mastered music from the mid, late 70s, some of it's absolutely phenomenal, but some of it also lacks the low end that you would attribute to a modern record. We've totally changed how we listen to music. And of course, it's not being mastered for vinyl anymore. It's being mastered in the digital world where there's a massive bandwidth and you have so much dynamic range. Not that it's always being utilized. So let's listen to some plugins. Okay, so let's start with the song we just finished up with on the SSL. And let's check out our options. Now, Waves makes a great SSL bus compressor, so let's check that out. So this is pretty fairly accurate to what we have going on in the console. So let's set it up similarly. And I went off auto and used some of the fast release as well and played around with the attack. But let's just get it, set it back. Everybody knows. fastest release. So it's essentially suffering from the same thing. Whatever I do, it has a similar effect that I was getting on the bus compressor, is that it's grabbing the low end first. That huge oomph that's coming out underneath the djembe, it's fantastic to listen to, but without a sidechain function on the compressor, it's not working. So if you're in like EDM music or anything with a huge amount of low end, you're going to want some kind of sidechain. I like the sound of the SSL Bus Compressor, Waves 1. It didn't really sonically impart quite the same sound that my SSL does, but you know, my SSL's old. I think it was built in 1986. And in 1986, I mean, that's a lot of old technology in there. I'm sure it passes current in a very different way over all of these years. And, you know, every analog piece of equipment varies. It just does. And if you lined up 20 1986 bus compressors together, at this point, I doubt if any of them will sound the same. Whether they're massively different is a whole other thing, because of SSL, of course, was an incredible company, or is an incredible company, I should say. So I'm going to grab the IK multimedia version. This is theirs. It's not called an SSL, but it's called the British Channel. And it has all the same functions, ratio between 1.5, 2, 4, and 10. There's attack, release. So I'll go to the auto function. We'll put the attack on its slowest point. We'll turn the threshold all the way down. We'll take the makeup off for a second. And we won't use the sidechain yet. This is going to be the differentiator. This thing here. Because that's going to let the low end breathe through. Okay, so let's bring the threshold. So I'm not going to use this grit control yet, because that's like an extra, like, second harmonic sparkliness. We'll get to that in a minute. But what I am going to do is put the sidechain in. Let's go to 150. Beautiful. So now that low end from that djembe, 150 hertz, is just passing through, and the compression is grabbing everything above that. So you can hear it, but if you just want a visual representation, look at the VU. I take that off. You can see and you can hear there's about 2 to 3 dB of compression just when the djembe low end hits. Back to 150 hertz. So now I'm getting that glue. I'm getting that top of the djembe just kind of starting to get me that SSL spankiness that we love. But the low end's passing through. And just for snitch and sniggles, let's hit the grit. Oh, sparkly. Bypass. That's out. Bring it in. That's fantastic. I mean, we're getting 1-2 dB gain reduction, but we're letting the low end pass through. We hit this grit control. It's exciting. Bypass it. That's nice. I'll put this on. So that's basically what master bus compression does. You can see what a useful tool it is to glue things together. Just because we can, let's see what other SSL style bus compressors we have. So Plug-in Alliance, Brainworks, make the Townhouse bus compressor. Those of you that don't know, the Townhouse we're talking earlier about, Hugh Padgham. I mean, he's synonymous with one of the greatest drum sounds of all time. And of course, the Townhouse compressor. So it's already defaulted to auto because they know what they're doing. We'll put it to the fastest attack time. We'll set the ratio to 4:1. We'll turn the threshold all the way off for the time being. We'll leave the game mic up where it is. We'll turn the compression off and we'll listen. Put the compressor in. That game makeup down. So this has a sidechain filter here, which is infinitely variable. Get some compression going. Turn it off, so no sidechain. That's really grabbing it hard. A bit more game makeup. So that's a lot of compression on the low end. To 138. Turn the compressor off. Bring it back on. Back on. I'm now going to turn on. Take that off. Turn on the Brainworks. I'm going to get the release time on the fastest here on the Brainworks. I feel like the auto function isn't working fast enough on the Brainworks compared with what's happening on the T-Rex, on the IK multimedia one. But now I like this, and I also like this infinitely variable sidechain. Get a little bit more surgical with it. Off again. Turn this one on. Bypass. Townhouse, turn it on. Everybody knows. So I've got the attack on the slowest time on the townhouse with the release on the fastest. If I go to the IK multimedia, I keep the release on the auto. It seems to figure it out faster. It seemed to apply the right kind of setting. So each of these SSL bus compressors, these SSL style bus compressors, have their own idiosyncrasies. And one thing, quite frankly, is they may well be modeled on different units. You know, I don't think either of these sound exactly like mine. I might hasten to say that maybe the townhouse sounds a little grungier, so maybe a little bit more analog, a little bit more, you know, wrong. The T-Rex is definitely hyped in a really cool way. This grit control is fantastic. But at the same time, it seems to be a little bit more hi-fi, if that makes any sense. It's adding these additional harmonics, but it keeps everything sounding a little bit more like it is. It doesn't impart so much analog kind of warmth, but it's definitely hyping the high end. It's definitely a little bit more hi-fi. I wonder, the T-Rex might be your mastering, you know, compressor. I mean, you can put it on your mix bus, of course. It would be amazing. But I think if I was doing mastering and I wanted the sound of an SSL, especially with the sidechain, that's pretty amazing. The townhouse, I know so many of my friends, mixers, that use this and love it. And I love it as well. Because you can get pretty nuts with it and get some great, great sounds. So I think this has got a lot of coloration. So let's see who else we've got. So I actually have a hardware version of the Vertigo VSC2, which does use the same VCAs, which I believe are the DBX original ones, like the 1202s, I think they are. I'm sure the experts below will let me know I'm saying it wrong, but that's okay. And what I like about the hardware, of course, is that it has this sidechain function. So we can keep this in stereo. We can treat it just like an SSL compressor. We can go here and set everything just the same way. And then we've got makeup here. Yeah, let's give it a listen. And we'll start with the sidechain. You know, I'm going to go up to 90. It doesn't go up to like the 138 or the 150 we've been doing. Let's have a listen and see what it does. What's winning in this case on this song is anything that can go above like about 120, 130 as a sidechain. This is great on a standard rock track where maybe the bass guitar is pushing like, you know, 80, 90, 100, and the kick drum is more like 60 and below. This would be perfect. But going through all of the ones that we've got, it's definitely the winner is going to be either the townhouse, which is infinitely variable, or going up to 500 with the T-Rex. So those are going to be the two. I actually love the sound of the Vertigo. And what we can do now is we can go quickly to the first track we listened to and apply all of these same compressors. And there are other SSL ones on the market, so you can experiment as well. So we're going to listen to the Ashley Watson track quickly. And I'm going to set the threshold back down to zero. And we're going to start off with the Ways SSL bus compressor. Let you go, cause it feels so bad. And I can't sleep, cause you're in my head. And I see all the things that you want to do. But it hurts, cause I know that they won't come true. Cause I've got a man, but you got me. Tied in a knot, so I can't see. Let you go, cause it feels so bad. And I can't sleep, cause you're in my head. And I see your go the fastest attack time. But
turn the threshold down. So now it's really just catching that kick. Go to a faster release time. Just catching the kick only. In it goes. So it's kind of cool. Knowing your tools is great. I think that's actually one of the most convincing things I've seen it do. It sounds very much like my SSL bus compressor there. We were getting similar results where it was catching the kick only. And if I want to control the kick only, what I've done there is I've gone to the fastest attack with the fastest release time. And it's actually getting that kick quite nicely and releasing quick enough that it doesn't squash and destroy the rest of my mix. So that is a win for that compressor. It's so difficult because, you know, you can have one tool or you can have 50 tools. You know, you can have a multiple versions of these compressors. And if you do, and you know what their attributes are, you can decide how to use them. Of course, with this compressor here, what I could do is I could double send to it. What I've done is I've duplicated the track and I'm going to send from the sidechain to it. I can send that pre-fade so I can mute the track. So what I'm doing is I'm duplicating the track and I'm sending to it. So what I'm doing here is I am sending a sidechained version of the song. So I'm wiping everything out below 150. So let's have a listen to that. Bypass it. Okay, so now I'm going to send that to my SSL bus compressor. I'm going to make it input bus 7. We are now sending from the other track where everything below 150 has been wiped off to this compressor, meaning none of the low end will control it. Have a listen to see what it does. Go back to auto, go back to the fastest attack. So the low end's still coming through. So look, if I really compress the song really aggressively, go to the fastest release time, fastest attack time. You can still hear all that low end in the mix. So you see what's going through? You've got low end of the kick, the bass guitar, the low end of the sax. Bypass it. That makeup gain. It's a cool little trick. That's one way you could get around if you didn't have available a compressor that had a sidechain function on it. You can just invent your own sidechain. So you duplicate the track, you wipe off all the low end, and then you let that duplicated track with no low end control the compressor. So it won't start compressing until it hears those mid-range. Either way, when you compress, you compress. So if you're compressing high mids and it's also like bringing, it's going to bring the whole signal down, you'll still hear the low end come down. But it does mean that the low end is not the only thing triggering the compressor. And that's the most important thing, because if the low end is always triggering the compressor, you'll get this kind of suck down every single time something like a bomb for djembe, a bass guitar, a stand-up bass, the boom of a 26-inch kick, you know, some EDM low-end, an 808, all of that stuff will be the only thing making that VU meter go mad, and your song will totally pump. Sometimes that's what you want. You want it in like an EDM dance track. You want that to happen. But in most instances, especially rock and roll, that's not what you want. So all of these tools are useful. They all have their own attributes. So you can manipulate something like the waves to do what you want it to do by using this function. You can use, for instance, the vertigo if you want something really super transparent. If you can use the townhouse, if you want something with lots of coloration, and we love it. So many mixers I know love that one. And of course, if you want the IK multimedia, the T-Rex bus compressor, you get that grit control and you get a little bit more of a hi-fi action. You don't quite get that sort of, even though it's got grit, it doesn't have that low mid kind of glueiness that an SSL has. But in some ways, I like that. You know, even though it doesn't sound exactly like my SSL bus compressor, it does serve the job really, really well. And it reminds me of, you know, why I want a bus compressor. It does the things that I want it to do. So they've all got their own attributes. Let's have a listen to the mix with just the T-Rex on it. Bypass it. Back in. So that's nice with the sidechain high pass up there. Turn that off, put on the SSL waves one. Cause I've got a man, but you got me. Tied in a knot so I can't see. Said you would go, cause it feels so bad. And I can't sleep, cause you're in my head. And I see all the things that you wanna do. But it hurts, cause I know that they won't come true. Cause I've got a man, but you got me. Tied in a knot so I can't see. Townhouse. Townhouse sounds pretty special. It's coloring it really nicely. Sidechain is still set, 138. Let's go to the vertigo. Bypass. That vertigo is pretty hi-fi. That's an awesome piece of equipment. The hardware is the same. But my preference with this song is the townhouse, because the townhouse is imparting so much, you know, character to it. It's mushing it up. It's gluing it together. I mean, it sounds like the graphic. You know what I mean? It sounds a little grungy. Go back to the vertigo. Huge difference. Sounds great. Very hi-fi. It's almost like I would be mixing with the townhouse and mastering with either, in this instance, with either the vertigo or the IK multimedia. There you go. It's horses for courses. It's knowing what you want and it's choosing the right tool for the job. We talk a lot about intention and this idea of optionitis. I think I don't really agree with that, because if you know your tools, like you know all these bus compressors here, and we've got four distinctly different sounding tools, two of them have similar ideas, like the vertigo and the IK multimedia are a little bit more hi-fi sounding, but the IK multimedia has that grit function, has more variability, can go high pass much, much higher than the vertigo can. So it's a bit, has more functions in that, but the vertigo is super hi-fi. I mean, if I was mastering and I wanted an SSL style bus compressor, I'd probably reach for the vertigo. If I want to maintain the integrity of the mix, But if I'm trying to color and bring personality to the mix, I'm going for the townhouse, which is why it's so popular with so many mixers. And the SSL one is very close to my SSL bus compressor. But if I wanted it to breathe with the low end, I'd have to do the sidechain trick and just trigger it from the high mids and not from the low end. So there you go. It's knowing your gear. Optionitis is basically going, I have too many options. Yeah, you have too many options because you don't understand why you would reach for a certain tool. It's always about intention. What do you want to do? Did you do a test like this? Do the same thing. If you've got different compressors that you want to use on your master bus, try them out. People ask me all the time, what would I use on my master bus? Well, I go, well, I use my SSL bus compressor. But if I was trying not to color, you know, I'd lean towards the Vertigo. If I wanted a more extended low end, probably the IK Multimedia. If I wanted to super color, once again, the townhouse. You see, I'm understanding what attributes they all have, allowing me to make a decision. And I think that understanding that means that you can move fluently between different styles of mixing, different styles of mastering, and not always have like one sound and one way of doing things. The thing about, and the great thing about having modern technology and having all of these plugins to choose from, is that we're able to make so many more decisions and not have to just work in our lane of like, these are the three things I know how to do. Now, as a home studio owner, as a mixer, you can mix in every different style. You can move across genres and do all kinds of stuff. You're not just limited by owning an SSL, which is going to give you a sound. We love it, but it gives you a sound. You can reach and do Neve sounds and API sounds and all kinds of things. And you can think outside of the box, literally, while still being inside the box. Anyway, let us know your particular experiences. There'll be a link to these plugins down below for those who want to purchase them. I highly recommend all of them. They all have their own strengths. Have a marvelous time recording and mixing, and we'll see you all again very, very soon. So long, farewell, auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, adios, goodbye.